Hi everyone, welcome to LMS, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. Myself, J.C. Ramya. In today's session, we are going to discuss about balancing, that is Unit 4 in Mechanics of Machines, 15ME32T, third semester, Diploma in Mechanical Engineering subject. This is our fifth session. Balancing. Session outcome. After this session, students will be able to understand the concept of balancing. Contents. Contents for the today's session, that is, we are going to solve problem on balancing of several masses rotating in the same plane by first one, analytical method. Second one, graphical method. Recap. These are the some formulas we are going to use to solve the problem by the analytical method. First one, centrifugal force Fc is equal to M into R. As a definition, centrifugal force is a product of mass and its radius. In a problem, for example, if we have four masses acting in a system, Fc1 will be equal to M1 into R1, Fc2 is equal to M2 into R2, Fc3 is equal to M3 into R3, Fc4 is equal to M4 into R4. Next step, resolve the centrifugal forces horizontally and find their sum, that is sigma h. Sigma h is equal to m1 into r1, that is the centrifugal force of first mass multiplied by cos theta 1, plus m2 into r2 cos theta 2, plus m3 into r3 cos theta 3, plus m4 into r4 cos theta 4. Resolve the centrifugal forces vertically and find out their sum. That is, sigma b is equal to m1 into r1 sin theta 1. That is, centrifugal force of first mass m1 into r1 multiplied by sin theta 1, plus m2 into r2 sin theta 2, plus m3 into r3 sin theta 3, plus m4 into r4 sin theta 4. After finding sigma b and sigma h, next we can find out the magnitude of resultant centrifugal force, that is Fc or R resultant is equal to root of sigma h square plus sigma b square whole square. If theta is the angle which the resultant force makes with the horizontal, then tan theta is equal to sigma b by sigma h. The balancing force is then equal to resultant, but it is in opposite direction. Now we can find out the magnitude of balancing mass such that Fc is equal to capital R is equal to Mb into Rb, where M is the balancing mass and R is the radius of rotations. Let us solve a problem. Four masses A, B, C and D are attached to a shaft and revolve in the same plane. The masses are 12 kg, 10 kg, 18 kg and 15 kg respectively, and their radius of rotations are 40 mm, 50 mm, 60 mm and 30 mm. The angular positions of the masses B, C, D are 60 degree, 135 degree and 270 degree from mass A. It is all the angles are with reference to the mass A. Calculate the magnitude and position of balancing mass at a radius of 100 mm. First, read out the problem and understand the problem, then write the given data. Given, MA is equal to 12 kg, RA, that is its radius, is equal to 40 mm, theta A, that is equal to 0 degree. Always, the first mass is taken as a reference, that is acting at the 0 degree. MB is of 10 kg, RB is of 50 mm, theta B, that is mass B is acting at 60 degree from mass A or with respect to mass A. MC is equal to 18 kg, RC is equal to 60 mm, theta C is equal to 135 degree. MD is equal to 15 kg, RD is equal to 30 mm, theta D is equal to 270 degree and R is equal to 100 mm. Next we need to plot the space diagram, that is the graphical representation of all the forces acting with their radius and angular position. That is, our mass A is of 12 kg with the radius of 40 mm acting at an angle of 0 degree. Our second mass is acting at an angle of 60 degree from mass A, that is of MB 10 kg at a radius of 50 mm. Our third mass MC is acting at 135 degree from mass A, that is of 18 kg and at the radius of 60 mm. Our fourth mass is acting at 270 degree from mass A, that is of 15 kg and at the radius of 30 mm. This is our space diagram. Let M be the balancing mass and theta the angle which the balancing mass makes with M1. Since the magnitude of centrifugal forces are proportional to the product of each mass and its radius, that is MA into RA, that is equal to 12 into 40, that is equal to 480 kg mm. Similarly, MB and RB, that is MB into RB, is equal to 10 into 50, that is equal to 500 kg mm. MC into RC, that is equal to 18 into 60, that is equal to 1080 kg mm. MD into RD, that is equal to 15 into 30, that is equal to 450 kg mm. After this, the problem can be solved either analytically or graphically, but we will solve the problem by both the methods. First one by analytically, and next we can solve this by graphical method. By analytical method, we will use some formulas to solve the problem. First one, the space diagram is as shown in the figure, just we have drawn the space diagram. Second, resolving the centrifugal forces horizontally, that is sigma h is equal to ma into ra multiplied by cos theta a plus MB into RB into cos theta B plus MC into RC into cos theta C plus MD into RD into cos theta D. That is equal to MA, the product of MA into RA is a 480 multiplied by cos theta C 0 degree. In calculator, you calculate first to cos 0 na enter maadi equals multiply that answer with the 480. plus 500 multiplied by cos 60 degree plus 1080 multiplied by cos 135 degree plus 450 multiplied by cos 270 degree. That is, after calculation, cos 0 is 1 multiplied by 480, that is 480 plus cos 60 degree is 0.5 multiplied by 500, that is equal to plus 250. Cos 135 is a negative value, that multiplied by 1080, that is equal to minus 763.67 plus cos 270, it's a 0. 0 multiplied by 450, it's a 0. After simplification, here we will get sigma h is equal to 33.67 kgmm. That is negative value minus 33.67 kgmm. Dissolving the centrifugal forces vertically. That is sigma v is equal to ma into ra sin theta a plus mb into rb sin theta b plus mc into rc sin theta c plus md into rd sin theta d. That is ma into ra, the product of first centrifugal force is equal to 480 multiplied by sin 0 degree plus mb into rb, that is the second centrifugal force, that is of 500 multiplied by sin 60 degree plus mc into rc, that is 1080 multiplied by sin 135 degree plus md into rd, that is 450 multiplied by sin 217 degree. That is sin 0, it's a 0, multiplied by 480, it is of 0. Sin 60 degree, that value multiplied by 500 gives us 433.012 plus sin 135 multiplied by 1080 gives us 763.67 minus sin 270 degree, it's a minus 1, multiplied by 450, it's a minus 450. Illi now sign kuda correct aagi consider maadbeku, whether it is a positive or negative. After simplification, sigma v is equal to 746.67 kg mm. Here the mass is at the unit of kg and radius is in unit of radius mm. So that is 746.67 kg mm. Next we can find out resultant. Therefore, resultant R is equal to root of sigma h whole square plus sigma v whole square. That is equal to root of minus 33.67 whole square plus 746.67 whole square. Illi negative ide antheli confuse agudbeda. When we take the whole square, that negative into negative, that gives a positive. So that our final answer is, after taking the square root, 747.42 kgmm. That is, is square root bandu eradu term ge thogobeku. So you first calculator alli square root hakidre ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಇದೆರಡೂ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ನ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 747.42 ಕೆಜಿ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ಮಾಸ್, the balancing mass and the radius, it is the balancing radius, it is equal to resultant R. So that is equal to 747.42 kgmm. Or M, that is equal to capital R by small r, that is equal to 747.42 divided by 100. that is m is equal to 7.47 kg. This is our final answer. The balancing mass is of 7.47 kg. Resultant angle tan theta is equal to sigma v by sigma h. That is, tan theta is equal to 746.67 divided by minus 33.67. That is equal to minus 22.176, where theta dash is equal to tan inverse of minus 22.176. That is, theta dash is equal to minus 87.4 degree. Since theta dash is the angle of resultant r from the horizontal mass of 12 kg, angle of resultant force is equal to 180 degree minus 87.4 degree, that is equal to 92.6 degrees. This is our angle of resultant force. Angle of balancing mass theta is equal to 180 degree plus 92.6 degree. That is equal to 272.6 degrees. Therefore, the balancing mass that we have calculated, m is equal to 7.47 kg, and it is acting at an angle of theta that is equal to 272.6 degrees. Next, we can solve the same problem by using graphical method. The magnitude and the position of balancing mass may also be found out graphically as discussed below. First, we need to draw the space diagram showing the positions of all given masses as shown in the figure. So this is our space diagram. MA is of 12 kg and at radius of 40 mm and it is acting at an angle of 0 degree. Our MB is acting at an angle of 60 degree from mass A, that is of 10 kg and at the radius of 50 mm. Our third mass is acting at an angle of 135 degree from mass A, and that is of 18 kg and at the radius of 60 mm. Our fourth mass is acting at an angle of 270 degree from mass A, and that is of 15 kg at the radius of 30 mm. Space diagram, that is a graphical representation of all the masses acting in a system and their radius value and their angular positions. First, we need to find out centrifugal forces. MA into RA, that is equal to 12 into 40, that is equal to 480 kg mm. MB into RB, that is equal to 10 into 50, that is equal to 500 kg mm. MC into RC, that is 18 into 60, that is equal to 1080 kg mm. MD into RD, that is equal to 15 into 30, that is 450 kg mm. Draw the vector diagram with the above values to some suitable scale. Centrifugal forces find out maadid mele graphical method alli solve madodike some suitable scale na select maadkobeku. So adike idralli maximum value yavudide adanna observe maadi suitable scale na select maadi. So that 1080, you can select the scale of 100 kg mm is equal to 1 cm. So considering the scale 1 cm is equal to 100 kg mm, draw a vector AB that is equal to 4.8 cm, which represents 480 kg/mm. That is, our first vector, it is acting at an angle of 0 degree. Draw a line AB that magnitude is equal to 4.8 cm, which represents 480 kg/mm in the direction towards B. So first line A, B, 4.8 cm ಗೆ draw ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, that is of 0 angle ಅಲ್ಲಿ. Second one, draw a vector BC is equal to 5 cm, represents 500 kg/mm. So already ನಾವು vector AB ನ draw ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, that is of 4.8 cm, representing 480 kg/mm. At the end of point B, protractor na nee place maadi, illinda angle na measure maadbeku, that is of angle 60 degree. A 60 degree angle line 5 cm ge draw maadbeku, that 5 cm represents 500 kg/mm. So that is our vector B to C, that is of 5 cm, which represents 500 kg/mm at an angle of 60 degree from mass A or from the reference line. Draw a vector CD that is equal to 10.8 cm, which represents 1080 kg/mm. So that is, already we have drawn vector AB and vector BC. At the end of point C, take a reference line, protractor na illi place maadi. So illi in the angle of 135 degree na measure maadi. So a 135 line, a 135 degree line estimate irbekandre, that should be of 10.8 cm. So which represents 1080 kg/mm. That is our C to D is acting in the direction of, that vector is in the direction of D. So AB is of 4.8 cm, BC is of 5 cm, CD is of 10.8 cm and at an angle of 135 degree. Next one, draw a vector DE that is equal to 4.5 cm, which represents 480 kg/mm. So already now vector AB draw maadidivi, BC draw maadidivi at an angle of 60 degree and CD draw maadidivi at an angle of 135 degree in the direction of D, and it is of 10.8 cm, which represents 1080 kg/mm. At the point of D, take a reference, place your protractor and measure the angle of 270 degree. So 270 degree alli draw a line of 4.5 cm which represents 450 kg/mm in the direction of E. So that is our vector DE. Last one, draw a line which closes AE and measure its distance. That is, already we have drawn AB, BC, CD and DE. So illi naavu, according to polygon law, we can define the closing end that represents the magnitude of resultant. So according to polygon law, 5 sides irbeku. So illi now already draw madiro vector is of 4 sides. The closing end enide, that represents the magnitude of resultant. So draw a line AE and measure its distance. So draw a line by a dotted line AE and measure its distance. So that is of 7.46 centimeters. And it is at the angle of theta dash is equal to 92.5 degrees. and it is in a direction towards E. So as a definition, the resultant is acting at the opposite direction of other vectors. So other vectors direction and the resultant direction is opposite. Next, we can consider that capital R resultant is equal to distance of AE multiplied by scale factor. So that is, distance is equal to 7.46 multiplied by 100, that is equal to 746 kg mm. That is, mass m is equal to r by small r, that is of 100, that is equal to 7.46 divided by 100. Our balancing mass is equal to 7.46 kg, and theta dash, that is equal to 92.5 degree, that is the angle of resultant force. Next, we can represent this on the space diagram. Our mass A, MA of 12 kg, MB of 10 kg, MC of 18 kg and MD of 15 kg, and our resultant R is of 92.5 degree, and our balancing mass is M is equal to 7.46 kg, and theta is equal to 272.6 degrees. This is one assignment question I have given. You can try this. Next, multiple choice questions. First question, the balancing is used in spiral elevators, airplanes, rotors and all of the above. As the balancing is very important in high speed vehicles or the machines which are running at the high speed. So it is used in spiral elevators also, and it is used in airplanes also, and it is used in rotors also. The correct answer is option D, all of the above. Second question. The resultant capital R is given by root of sigma h square plus sigma v square. Option B, sigma v multiplied by sigma h. Option C, sigma v minus sigma h. Option D, sigma v plus sigma h. Correct answer is option A, resultant R is equal to root of sigma h square plus sigma v square. Third question, the space diagram is used to show the position of several masses in a graphical way. Whether the statement is true or false. So far now tumba problems solve maadidivi, so adralli now already many times discuss maadidivi. The space diagram, that is to show the positions of several masses and their radius and their angular positions in a graphical way. That is, the correct answer is option A, this statement is true. Next question, the unit of sigma h is option A, Newton, option B, kg, option C, kg meters, option D, none of the above. The correct answer is option C, kg meter. That is, the masses acting, the value will be in kg, and their radius, it is in a meters. Next question. In a graphical method, the resultant force is found out by option A, polygon law of forces, option B, Lamy's theorem, option C, hexagon law of forces, option D, none of the above. So problems graphically solve maadbekidre many times now discuss maadidivi. That is, four forces represents the four vectors, so that is a four sides. The fifth side, that is a closing side, yadide, that that will gives us the magnitude of resultant. So the main intention to find out the resultant value, that is our system alli 5 sides ide ant heldanga, that is related to polygon law of forces, that is a 5 sides. So in a graphical method, the resultant force is found out by option A, the polygon law of forces. The correct answer is option A. These are all the few references link I have gone through. Thank you. And these are all my team members. Thank you very much.